moon, our closest friend, our needy neighbour who has been orbiting us for 4.51 billion years. The moon is a great source of inspiration for us humans and a way of life for many nocturnal animals, the great tide controller and a suspected mood influencer. So, what would happen to us if we lost our big, bright, beautiful friend? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, a channel that loves to stop for a moment and do some thinking. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if the moon disappeared? In short, I, along with the rest of the planet Earth, would be very upset. Before I answer this question, though, I want to ask you a question. Do you think that people get crazier on a full moon? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. I'm actually inclined to say, yeah. I think they might. If you like our channel, please do show me by leaving a thumbs up on this video. And if you haven't yet clicked on that big, beautiful notification bell, why don't you do so you always stay up to date with big answers. Stick around to the end of the video, as I'm going to be reading comments from a previous one. So, if the moon disappeared, what then? Well, to me, it doesn't bear thinking about. I love the moon. I will argue that the moon is one of the reasons we are where we are in terms of space travel and technological advancement. We looked up at night and saw something we didn't know, so we spent millennia figuring out what it was. Then we left planet Earth and physically got there. Isn't that absolutely amazing? I would argue that planet Earth, yes, sure, but civilization, majorly, would have developed far differently if there was never a moon. Although that isn't the focus of our question today. It's what if it disappeared, and well, not necessarily the same as disappearing per se, but actually, I've got news for you. The moon is leaving us, and one day it might well be gone. It seems that the moon is moving away from the Earth at the rate of 4 centimeters a year, which, I mean, actually, that's quite a lot, isn't it? It's uncertain whether or not the moon would actually ever reach escape velocity, but the distance would slow the Earth down considerably. But when it comes to this video, we aren't going with a slow fade, we're going with a poof, the moon's gone. So, first things first, would we even notice straight away? Depending on where we were in our 29.5 day moon cycle, the moon vanishing could momentarily go unnoticed, surrounding a new moon evening. That is, until the chaos set in, which of course it would. So, shall we start with the water? Most of us know that the moon controls our tides, although that actually is only a half truth. The real situation is that the moon is the biggest influencer of our water, but the sun does hold a gravitational sway. Without the moon, tides would be 40% the size that they are today, which actually would be a very big issue. Firstly, at the moment, tidal flow mixes up ocean waters, which works to spread nutrients to marine life across the ocean. Without this process, or decreasing this process, it would mean that a lot of marine life would simply die out, which then would have a knock-on effect on the food chain. Humans, for example, would have less fish as food sources. While we wouldn't die out like whales and other marine life could, we would have to focus on filling the gap by sourcing food elsewhere. Overfarming of cattle is already an issue and would become even a bigger issue. And I also imagine the lack of ocean-sourced food would encourage a famine that would worst affect places like China, Myanmar, Vietnam, Japan, Iceland. These are all countries that eat the most fish. It isn't just sea animals that would be freaked out and possibly die. Nocturnal animals wouldn't be able to hunt in the same way that they do now, which could lead to another mass extinction on the land. Extinctions and hunger would be issues, but they wouldn't be our only problems. While our gravity most definitely affects the moon's gravity steadies us too. Without the moon in the sky, the Earth may wobble on its axis, which would mean very inconsistent weather. The sun would shine more erratically on various parts of the Earth. Long term, this would affect climate, and also our normal process of heating and cooling would be disturbed. It's hard to predict exactly what would happen, but it would likely change our axial tilt. Plus, the Earth may spin slightly faster too, making our years shorter. Things would be pretty messed up. Oh, and we'd also likely be exposed to asteroids too, because the moon currently acts to attract celestial bodies and stops them from hurtling to Earth. If the moon disappeared, if we had time amongst all of the Earth wobbling and natural disasters, or like, wouldn't people be majorly freaking out? The moon is a big part of a lot of religions, and even if people don't worship the moon or consider the moon to be part of their religion, a lot of people would still be freaking out, thinking that it was some kind of apocalypse, and could you blame them? A big bright celestial body a quarter of the size of the Earth just upped and disappeared. Would we be next? Who or what took the moon? Where did it go? Would it ever be coming back? What if aliens took our moon hostage? What would we do then? Honestly, it's all getting a bit ridiculous, and To be fair, so far as we know, the moon simply cannot disappear. It's quite unlikely to be leaving our orbit anytime soon, too, so rest assured, or as assured as you can be without knowing truly who made the universe or what made the universe and how it was formed and what other civilizations out there might be capable of. Okay, so that was quite a quick one for you today, but what would you do if the moon disappeared? Do you think that people get crazy surrounding the full moon? I definitely do feel a bit of an energy shift myself. Before I go, I'm gonna read some comments from one of my most recent videos, What If the Ark of Covenant Was Real? Jungalo Madness Review said, the Ark of the Covenant is real, it always ends up west. Many people believe the Ark of Covenant is in Oak Island in Nova Scotia, Canada, and that's where they're trying to find money pits, because the Ark of the Covenant might be there. Oh my goodness, to Nova Scotia! Anthony Rue said, the Vatican has the Ark. Think about it. That's why the Vatican archives are locked up tighter than the White House. Honestly, I can think of a few other reasons that security at the Vatican might be tight, but, you know, Ark, sure. Daniel Hansen said, knowledge ain't power, power is power. All hail Queen Cersei. Wait, where's Queen Cersei now? I heard that she can't come to the throne or the phone. But wait, who is on the throne? Oh, that's right, Mr. Three-Eyed Raven of all knowledge and wisdom, that's who. That's right, knowledge is power. Power is, you know, kind of helpful. So guys, that is all I have time for today. Why don't you leave me your moon-based thoughts in the comments section down below? And a moonmoji never, never, never fails to disappoint me. So go for it. If you haven't liked our video yet, then please do leave a thumbs up. And why don't you subscribe to become part of our Life's Biggest Questions family? I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, please do stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.